My name is Elizabeth Carlson, and I am the honors biology teacher at Hamilton High School. And two summers ago, I was lucky enough to be selected to participate in the RET program, the Research Experience for Teachers at UC and sponsored by the National Science Foundation. After spending six amazing weeks in a genetics lab and falling in love with UC, I met our next speaker on the day of our final presentations. I started following him on Twitter, and I just posted a selfie with him. Dr. Santa J. Ono is the president of the University of Cincinnati. UC is among the nation's top public research universities and has a record-breaking enrollment of 44,200 students. Dr. Ono is recently honored by the American Council on Education with its Reginald Wilson Award for Excellence in Diversity Leadership and was selected to the ACE Board of Directors and the Ohio Chamber of Commerce Board. He is also a research scientist who focuses on eye disease and immunology, is an avid user of social media, and is very active in the greater Cincinnati community. Please welcome Dr. Ono to Hamilton High School.
Thank you very much. I think this is my third visit to the great Hamilton High School. It's great to be here at the home of the Big Blue. Even though I'm wearing red, I apologize for that. But every single time that I come back to this school, I'm incredibly impressed. And I've been here for different kinds of occasions, for athletic events, and the facilities here are absolutely first rate. That's something that the University of Cincinnati and Hamilton High School have in common, is really an inspiring physical plan. This is something that I know has happened relatively recently. And I think the story is very similar for Hamilton itself. The really historic renovation of the High Street part of Hamilton is something that is exciting. You can feel the electricity here. What's happening in the Clifton area and in Cincinnati itself and over the Rhine, these sorts of positive developments in space have a lot to do with the energy and the mood of a community. But more important than that, one of the things I realized in speaking to a lot of the people in this room over the past 10 to 20 minutes is that what's more important than bricks and mortar is the stuff of life, what's in your soul, what's in your heart, and the kinds of bonds that don't connect buildings together, but the kinds of bonds that connect individuals in the community together. You know, and when I speak to people here and I ask them, why are you excited about Hamilton High School? Why are you excited about Hamilton? The answers that I get are, it's pervasive. That it occurs at every single level of this high school, from the students all the way up to the principal, all the way up to the superintendent, that this positive attitude, this commitment to this place, transcends the building, the buildings, and really is something that lies at the very core of this community, every single person here. And it is, I'll tell you, inspiring. You have found the secret sauce of what it takes to bring the community together. I want to congratulate you on so many different achievements. Your dance team, I understand, on their recent visit to the Nationals in Indianapolis, placed first. The University of Cincinnati shares that as well. We have a dance team that we're awfully proud of, that have been world champions a number of times and national champions many, many times. And besides that connection, UC and Hamilton, as you know, have a lot of other connections. I understand from talking to the principals here that many of the principals here actually received their bachelor's degree or their master's degree from the College of Education, Criminal Justice, and Human Services from the University of Cincinnati. And we're proud of the leadership that our graduates are showing every day at this high school as well as in Hamilton itself. You know that there are 119 Big Blue graduates on our campus right now, and all in all, there are 14,000 Butler County residents that are Bearcats. So we talked a little bit about Dayton. We didn't talk about who Dayton was beating in the NCAA tournament. And a certain prefix, the, which appeared in the Dayton paper. But no, I was proud. I was absolutely serious that one of the things that I do as the University of Cincinnati president is cheer for all the teams. It's not just about what's happening in Clifton. It's not just about the University of Cincinnati about the Bearcats. It's what's happening in this region of the great state of Ohio. We should all be rooting for each other because it takes collective action, all of us rowing in the same direction to make this community, the region, and the state as great as it can be. You know, that's what makes, as I said, a community special. You know, we are really honored to have in this room a number of people that we hold dear at the University of Cincinnati, and you hold dear as well. There's an iconic person here, and there are many, but one of the individuals that we share our love for is someone called James L. Winkle. I don't know how many of you know that not only is he a graduate of Hamilton High School, but he is an iconic figure in the field of pharmacy. If you go to pharmacies and you actually look at how they dispense medicines and the practice and the art of being a pharmacist, the science of being a pharmacist, a lot of that was pioneered at the University of Cincinnati in the College of Pharmacy. And there is no individual that has had a bigger impact on the success of the top-rated pharmacy school in Ohio than your own graduate, James L. Winkle, after whom our college is named, the James L. Winkle College of Pharmacy. Let's all give him a round of applause. There's a gentleman who's a very senior partner who I had of a major law firm in Cincinnati that I've had the privilege of getting to know over the past several months. He's a person of integrity. He's a person that has incredible intellect, but is also a person of integrity. I've learned a lot from having conversations with him, and some difficult conversations. And that is another graduate of Hamilton High School, Nate Lampley, a lawyer working with the University of Cincinnati. Let's hear it for Nate. That's great news that the Hamilton City School District is also one of only 10 districts out of Ohio's more than 600 districts to earn an A grade for kindergarten through third grade literacy improvement. I'm a co-chair of something called the Read On campaign. It's something that I really am very passionate about, and that is to try to get all of the kids in this region reading at grade level well before the third grade. That involves all kinds of things, such as the preschool promise, but also really thinking intentionally about how we can come together to make sure that all of the children that are growing up in this region are able to read, something that's going to be incredibly important in determining their success in the future as adults in this region. We really need to come together and think about how we can improve and lift up their lives, just as you are lifting up the lives of the youth in this area by collective action. You know, when I was thinking about these questions that we've just been engaged in, the student engagement questions, how do you show pride in your community while still embracing each other? When I listened to some of the students saying that you show pride by actually really listening. You show pride by really genuinely caring about each other. You show pride by not being shy about talking about and shouting about all the great things that are happening in this high school and in this city. And then the other question about what is something that for the adults that you didn't take advantage of in your youth that you wish you knew that would have helped you become a stronger adult? And, you know, one of the things that I said was that I wish that when I was in grade school or in high school, that I turned to my right or turned to my left, talked to somebody that was 40 or 50, 60 or 80, that I talked to my grandparents. I think one of the biggest missed opportunities that we have can be solved, and you've actually taken a step to doing that right here today, in having intensely, intergenerationally mixed groups And with those questions, really catalyzing the kind of dialogue that happens far too infrequently. You know, what I said to the students at the table is one of the things that I wish I did was to listen to my grandparents and to truly listen to them. You know, I'll tell you, in my family, when the grandparents, my parents get together with my kids, everybody's in a rush. The kids are looking at their cell phones, talking to each other in the other room on their cell phone. It doesn't make any sense to me. Taking pictures of each other, Snapchat, you know, it is interesting. But, you know, in the excitement and the glitz of modern technology, one of the things that I say to young people is don't forget real connectivity, especially with those in your family, your grandparents, the teachers that are here that love you, the alumni that are here that don't have to be here because they love the school and they love you. Don't miss those opportunities. There's nothing more precious than that, and you can learn an enormous amount from your grandparents and the elders in the community. That's the one thing that I didn't do as a youth, that you have set up intentionally in this school, in this community. It's the essence of what a community is about. Take advantage of that, because it will enrich your life immeasurably and help you on your path to being an outstanding human being and citizen. But my biggest wish is that what you've done here at Hamilton High School, setting it up so that the youngest and best students and the students that also need help can talk to alumni and principals and superintendents across from the table, breaking bread, the best way to really build that kind of community. My biggest wish is that we can take your secret sauce here and spread it across the entire region and entire state of Ohio. You know, getting back to the introduction about how I rooted for the University of Dayton in that NCAA tournament, let's all do that. You know, I was asking the students, what do you think about what's happening in Hamilton and Hamilton High School? And they said, it's great. What's happening in the past year on High Street's amazing. What's happened with the new gym and the facilities here is exciting. And I said, what do you think about Dayton? What do you think about Cincinnati? And they said they love going to Cincinnati. Some of them have brothers or sisters that go to the University of Cincinnati. So you can be part of an amazing movement. What you've done here inspires us in Cincinnati, inspires us at the University of Cincinnati. And you all have connections all over the state, all over the region. And that enthusiasm that you communicate here, spread some of it and spend some time connecting with other parts of the state. Show that love, even to your rivals. I even cheer for Xavier. Please don't quote me on the news. I even root for Ohio State University when they're not playing us, because they're part of Ohio. And Xavier is a Cincinnati team. And so we are all in this together. Hamilton High School, the University of Cincinnati, yes, Xavier, yes, Ohio State.
And Miami University.
And Miami University. We have to collaborate, you know, because it's not a competition. It's about collective impact. It's about lifting up the whole region for the benefit of the next generation. You know, I get asked often when I speak in different places around the world about what I think about the millennial generation, what I think about you guys. You guys may not know this, you're called a Generation Z. I would rather be called a Generation Z than the Baby Boomer generation. Baby Boomer generation. What does that mean anyway? Baby Boomer, I don't know. But Generation Z. You know, and there was actually something in the Cincinnati paper not that long ago where somebody was actually critical of the millennial generation. And I got on Twitter, and one of the first things I did was come to the defense of the millennial generation and Generation Z. I mean, did you hear these two students speak? Did you hear any entitlement in them? Did you notice that they're grateful to be part of this school, to be part of this country. I'll tell you, I have a lot of experience with Generation Z and millennial students. And one of the most optimistic aspects of this nation is that in those conversations, when I compare and contrast the millennials and the Generation Z young adults to what I was as a baby boomer, they're far ahead of what we were. We were much more focused on our careers. It was a me generation. And one of the most optimistic things I have about the future of this high school, this county, and this state, and the University of Cincinnati, is the attitude and the principles and ethos and ethics and mores of the Generation Z in millennial students. I have never seen a generation that's more focused on we than me. And so I just want to end up and congratulate you, all of you, for the tremendous achievement that is Hamilton High School. You are a beacon of light for not only education in this region, you are a beacon of light for how to build community and how to focus on we over me. Congratulations to all of you.